And the breaking news is about a massive protest going on outside the British High Commission in Delhi with the protests against the referendum 2020. A US-based Sikh separatist organization referendum protest is to be held in London on the 12th of August. Demonstrators from the Sikh community and civil society under the banner of All India Anti-Terrorist Front chanted anti-UK and anti-Pakistan slogans. They were seen holding banners that read, and I quote, UK supporting ISI project codenamed Express and don't shelter ISI and Pakistan sponsored elements. Now, in fact, the UK, the United Kingdom, had refused to stop the protests in London, alleging that citizens have right to protest within legal limits.
परमजीत सिंह पम्मा जो है और उसके साथ कई टेररिस्ट हैं वो वांटेड हैं उनको वापस लाने के लिए हम पूरी कोशिश करेंगे हम अपने गवर्नमेंट के ऊपर भी दबाव डालेंगे और हमारी गवर्नमेंट उनके ऊपर भी दबाव डाले और हम भी बार बार यूके हाई कमीशन के पास ये प्रोटेस्ट करते रहेंगे कि हमें वापस दो
दिस इज अ प्रोटेस्ट रैली टू काउंटर द रेफरेंडम रैली दैट इज टू बी हेल्ड इन लंदन ऑन द 12th ऑफ ऑगस्ट द एंटी टेररिस्ट फ्रंट हियर इन न्यू दिल्ली बी हेल्ड Sumitra is protesting and is taking this march from Teen Murti to the British High Commission where they are going to protest against the fact that UK has allowed such rallies to be held which are secessionist in nature in the United Kingdom. With Vijay Journalist Satya in New Delhi, Geeta Mohan for India Today.
Executive Editor Gaurav Savan joins us for more on this. And Gaurav, tell us a little bit more about this protest going on here in the national capital. The MEA, in fact, had issued a strongly worded demarche to the British government against a rally that has been planned in London. So why is it that this rally has been allowed here in India?
The rally that's happening in London is a pro-Khalistan rally, which is being organized by secessionists, terrorists and their supporters. Aided and abetted by Pakistan's ISI and India Today has details of Pakistan ISI officers who are orchestrating this rally with overseas, a small section of overseas Sikhs and a bigger section of Kashmiris from Pakistan occupied Kashmir or Mirpuris in the United Kingdom. India objected to that rally. Of course, Britain said that it's freedom of expression, but secessionists, terrorists wanted, terrorists being a part of a rally isn't freedom of expression. But be that as it may, the rally that's happening in Delhi, Avantika, is against that rally in the United Kingdom, asking the British High Commission, the High Commissioner and authorities in Britain that an anti-India rally should not be permitted because a spark neglected can burn the house and Punjab has suffered at the hands of Pakistan state-sponsored terror in the mid-80s.
True, absolutely. And what about the Indian government? You know, have they just let matters be after the British government made it clear that everybody is allowed to protest within their legal limits? Or will they pursue the matter ahead of that rally that is scheduled in London?
So as of now, India is adopting a wait and watch strategy. Britain has, however, assured that they will keep a very keen eye on this rally and ensure that there is nothing that violates the law of the land that is permitted there. But more than the Indian government, Avantika, it's the Indian diaspora in the United Kingdom. They are raising awareness against this Pakistan state-sponsored rally against the Khalistanis, against the terrorists from Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, and exposing this entire game plan that is there. So all the propaganda that the Khalistanis attempted to do or Pakistan state-sponsored terror attempted to do is being very effectively countered by the Indian diaspora, not just on the social media, but effectively, both in England and elsewhere.
Absolutely. Foreign Affairs Editor Geeta Mohan is also joining us. And Geeta, tell us a little bit more about that protest. We just saw your report. In fact, the rally that has been arranged to be held in London has drawn a very sharp reaction from the Indian government. But just tell us more about what happened at the British Commission here in Delhi.
There are a few things that happened. One is that the anti-terrorist front headed by MS Bitta. They held a protest on the streets leading up to the UK High Commission, after which a memorandum was delivered, was handed over to the UK High Commissioner Dominique Asquith by Bitta, seeking and urging the UK government to look into India's concerns, take into account India's concerns, and stop that referendum rally taking place in London at the Trafalgar Square. Having said that, Avantika, there are a few things that have happened even in London. Not just the Indian community and the Indian diaspora coming out and countering the referendum rally with their own event that they will be holding at the very same venue. There, a protest was lodged by the Indian High Commission, but more importantly, what sources have told India Today is that the UK, that the Indian High Commission in the United Kingdom is going to closely monitor this entire referendum rally, and there are various MPs who have urged their own constituents not to participate in that rally because in future it could get difficult for them to travel to India, and that will be happening when the Indian High Commission monitors all those who are participating and siding with secessionist movements and secessionist elements in London and in the United Kingdom.
Absolutely. Gaurav and Geeta, just kindly stay on with me for the next breaking news as well. Ahead of the anti-India Khalistan rally in London on the 12th of August, India has alerted its missions of several separatist rallies in other countries as well. In fact, sources have told India Today that pro-Khalistan outfit Sikhs for Justice is planning several more anti-India rallies in Europe, Australia, New Zealand, United States and Canada. India has launched a very strong protest on the pro-Khalistan rally that's going to be held on the 12th of August and is going to be spearheaded by Khalistan leader Paramjit Singh Pamma. India is quite worried because Kashmiri separatists have also lent their support to this particular rally. Recently, United Kingdom authorities refused to ban the protest, stating that people had right to protest within law. But Gaurav, I mean, why is it that the United Kingdom is not responding to the, you know, strongly worded demarches and the note verbals from India's side? Because India and UK have shared very cordial relations, and not just that, the Indian diaspora or the number of Sikhs residing in the United Kingdom has also shared a very good relation with the government in UK. And if they have expressed so much resentment to the rally, why is it being allowed to take place?
Avantika, it's being seen as, you know, freedom of expression. So there are rights that individuals enjoy in any democracy. And that is what Britain is saying, that look, it's their freedom of expression. It, as long as they don't violate the law of the land, they're permitted to say what they will. They're, after all, British citizens who are objecting. So these are second generation, third generation people living there, many under the influence, or at least some under the influence of the Khalistani elements who may have fled India. At the height of counter-terror operations. So, you know, that is not as much a cause for concern as is Pakistan's state support. And that, again, is something that India has given other countries evidence of, how Pakistan ISI officers are working along this. And UK itself, incidentally, is a victim of Pakistan's state-sponsored terror. Lashkar-e-Taiba sleeper cells have been found in UK. You know, you were just telling us about how there's a similar rally planned in the United States and in Canada. Remember, Lashkar-e-Taiba has sleeper cells both in the US and in Canada.